guys, in today's video I will be showing you how to cook delicious ogbono soup, mouthwatering Nigeria soup. I added cow leg, now I'm adding hard chicken, superhuhn, and I will be adding the spices to parboil. If today is your first day joining, I am Chikwado, and you are in Chikwado space. Keep watching and don't forget to give my video thumbs up and like and subscribe. Just added the spices, onions and water in it. I will go ahead now to give it a stir, and I will cover to cook for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, I will check how the chicken, cow leg, and the hard chicken. The hard chicken, cow leg is doing. Now I will now see that it's cooking well. I will go ahead and add my pork meat. This is a flesh pork meat. I will be using pork meat also, and I will be using stockfish. I added my stockfish and the cow and the pork meat, and I will add water to cook. I will add also salt for taste. I will stir it very well to prime and cover to cook for 5 to 6-7 minutes. After that, I will check it, you know, because of the chicken there, hard chicken, I will cook it long. I will add now dry fish. Two dry fish, guys. This dry fish will bring the taste to the next level. I like using dry fish whenever I'm cooking. Although it's not easy to have dry fish here in Germany, but I try to get it. After adding it, I will turn it very well and cover it to cook again. Here you can see the ogbono. This is the ogbono after blending. And you can see by the left side, this is the ogbono when have not blended. In case if you don't know what is ogbono, this is the opportunity for you to know what is ogbono. This is how the seed looks like before it's blended to be in this way, the one I'm touching. So ogbono soup is a wonderful thickener that will make your soup draw, just like okro soup. Okay, and it's so heady. So I'll go ahead now to put a small pot on the fire, and I added my red oil. I'll be using red oil, and I will pour this ogbono, blended ogbono. I'll be turning it. Now you can see there is no heat on it. I'm just trying to melt the ogbono with the red oil. I will add the stock meat, or stock water I use on this chicken and everything. I will add it, and now add a small heat to warm or cook it. It will be turning it very well. You see this ogbono is going to rise more. As you are going to turn it, it will be rising. Depending on the quantity of soup you want, you'll be turning and be checking it. It is now cooking. Don't cook it too much. I will go ahead and add other things I needed. I add much water because I want my soup to be in a little big quantity. Okay. So I added water, normal water, to cook a little bit. Be turning it so much so that very well, so that it will not get burnt. Okay, just keep watching. Ogbono soup is so heady, it draws, it makes you to swallow your swallow so easily, just like okro soup, as I said before. They are heady in this, stay heady to your stomach and make you to be heady. Yes, it can prevent all these manner of stomach diseases and sickness. So I added more water because it is thick. Okay, I added more water and begin to turn. As I'm turning it, it is cooking. You know, you need to cook ogbono well. Okay, now I will go ahead and add my pepper. I'll be adding the dried pepper, blended pepper, and crayfish. Just added the crayfish and the blended dried pepper. I will go ahead and add one of my Maggi cube. Yeah, feel free to use any cube of your choice. I will add in only one and I will continue to turn it. I will be mixing everything I will be using to this soup in this ogbono, and I will stir it very well. Okay, just keep watching. And I check that it is not, it's still thick. I added more water and begin to turn. Okay, depending on the thickness you want, some people don't know how to make this. Now I will show you step by step how you can make it. As you are adding, you will see the consistency of this water. If you want your ogbono to be more thick, don't add much water. And if you want it to be a little lighter, because I don't want my own to be too thick. So do you see how it is now? It is not too thick. It is not also watering. And this is how I want it. This is how you can cook a perfect ogbono. Because I don't like when I'm eating ogbono, all my clothes will be dirty with ogbono. No, I want it to be light, not to draw. So I will be going ahead to add it in the main pot of this ogbono soup. Okay, I'll add it all there and I'll go ahead to give it a thorough stir to mix all the cow leg, all the meat, everything mix very well. I'll be using fresh bitter leaf in this soup. This bitter leaf will bring the taste to the next level, guys. I don't want to add much bitter leaf. This is okay for me. I like when ogbono is a little bit plain. Do you see how it is? This is how I want it. What do you see? It looks so delicious. Go ahead and check whether the salt is okay. I added a little bit of water from the pot. Yeah, I rinsed the pot and added the water there because I needed more water in the ogbono. Okay, now I test it. I will add a small salt for taste. Yeah, so you can see that this ogbono looks mouth-watering. It looks so delicious. I will cover to cook for 2 to 3 minutes. Don't forget to turn it regularly so that it will not get burnt. Now you see it is so perfect and delicious. Oh my God. Guys, in fact, bring your ogbono, bring your fufu, bring your garri, bring your yam fufu. Whatever you want to eat this in, bring it, let's eat together. Let me know if you are going to try this ogbono. Try it and let me know what you think in the comment section. Okay, don't forget to like, subscribe, and give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. I love you, and I will see you next time in my next video. Do you see how delicious this looks? So yummy. Thank you, and bye for now. Love you.